You've probably heard the adage that the best camera is the one that you have with you. Well, in my opinion, the best email marketing tool is the one that you'll actually use. Now, it's 2019 and email marketing tools are plentiful. Some offer beautiful templates while others offer exhaustive automation options. So that's why I was surprised to see Sumo Group themselves throw their hat in the ring with their own email service provider, or ESP for short. SendFox is light on features but promises to be fast, usable, and provide great deliverability. So right up front, if you're looking for an LTD on something like ActiveCampaign, this is not for you. But if you're a content creator that just needs to keep in touch with your subscribers, well, that's exactly who SendFox is hoping to serve. So how does it hold up? Well, in this review, I'll be walking through each of the features, and then I'll also test the deliverability versus Amazon SES, which is a little bit of the industry standard for email deliverability. So let's get started. The deal at AppSumo is pretty simple to understand. $49 gets you lifetime access and up to 5,000 contacts. Stack another code, get another 5K in contacts. Once you hit three codes, you'll have SendFox branding switch from an image to light text. Now, I'd really like to see the branding completely removed. Sumo Group has a habit of branding their tools, and I'd love to see them realize or listen when most customers say that they don't want to have branding on the products that they're displaying to their customers. So after you redeem your AppSumo purchase, the first thing you'll need to do is fill out your account details to comply with the CAN spam laws. You'll notice right away that the UI is very bare bones. Sumo Group did not waste any time or money hiring a fancy graphic designer. And you know what? I think I'm okay with that. Emails should be fast, simple, and mainly text, in my opinion. Studies show that text emails hit the inbox much more frequently, and you can't convert someone if your email doesn't get read. So, digging into the app, there is a startup checklist to get you going. But oddly, the checklist didn't display after I updated my account details. So, after feeling temporarily disoriented, I clicked on the SendFox logo in the corner, and then I received the prompt to follow the checklist again. So, the startup checklist will essentially take us through the entire platform, so I figured it was worth showing in this review. Step one is to add subscribers, which can be done either via CSV or by auto-importing from MailChimp. I don't have a MailChimp account to do the testing, so I'll have to assume it functioned properly. I'd love to know if you try it out, so leave a comment down below and let me know how it works. Now, most people will want to import a list of some kind, so assuming you're not using MailChimp, that's going to mean CSV. I was happy to see that they have a CSV template for you to start from, but I want to point out that the prompt to download the template doesn't display until after you choose the CSV file as a source, and the file picker basically masks the option to download the template. It's a little bit of an oversight in the UI department, in my opinion. I bet a lot of people will miss this the first time they try to upload some contacts. So I downloaded their template, I added a single email address, and then I uploaded it back to SendFox. Now, experienced email marketers will notice right away that you're creating something called a list when you upload the CSV file, and you might get a little bummed out because that is a very old-fashioned way to organize your contacts. The TLDR on this is that the entire email industry has moved on from lists and now relies on tags. Even longtime list-based giants like MailChimp have come around and now suggest using one list with tags to sort the contacts. So I was really bummed when I noticed this until I saw the URL for create lists. Dashboard/tags/create. Well, what do you know? Maybe SendFox is using tags and it will be more powerful than I had originally thought. So I went ahead and created my first list, uncreatively calling it test. Now, before I move ahead any further, it's worth noting that if you don't have a list and you just want to start from scratch, you can just skip the add context portion altogether. You won't really miss anything else. So after creating your first list, you'll be pushed over to the list screen. Now, this is an important screen. Here you can see your subscribers, check important stats like your open rate, clicks, and bounce rate. You can also manually add contacts or even delete your list entirely. The next thing SendFox wants you to do is try to send an email. So click on emails and from the menu, hit create email. You'll want to give your email a title so you can identify it in the SendFox platform later. Now don't worry, this title is just for you to see. Next, you'll be taken to a very basic text editor to compose your email, and I do mean very basic. You'll be able to set the from name and from email address. In the to field, you'll select the list you want to send the emails to, and then you're ready to compose. Now this is bare bones. We're talking about your choice of three fonts, sans serif, serif, or monospace. This is just the very minimum text features with the ability to add your own images. And if you think you'll be able to resize the images after you insert them into the email, you're sadly mistaken. SendFox doesn't bother to help you with these primitive tasks, so you'll need to make sure you get it right before uploading. Now, there are a few personalization options, so you can make sure that your recipient's name or email address actually displays in the email. However, you need to manually type these in. There's no menu to select them like you'll see on most email tools. Now, once my email is ready to go, I hit save, which oddly kicked me out of the email creation screen altogether and put me back in the email overview. So I headed back into the composition screen, scheduled the email to go out to my subscribers, and hit schedule. At that point, I hit save again, expecting to go back to that overview screen, but it just sat there. So I manually went back to the overview screen. Now here I was given the option to send a test email, a feature that I would expect to see before I was given the option to schedule. It would make a lot more sense to see that in the compose screen. Now, even though I'd already scheduled my email, I still hit test because I wanted to try out the feature. Now, both the real email as well as the test email hit my inbox really quickly, and they did feature that SendFox branding. That's something, again, I need to stack three codes to move it from an image to a text version of their branding. Both the real email and the test email hit my inbox quickly, and they did feature that SendFox branding. Now, remember, I would need to stack three codes to switch that out from an image over to text. So let's talk about the autoresponder. SendFox does give you the ability to create automation series or a drip sequence so that when people sign up for your email list, you can have an automated series of emails go out to them. Now, this is a core feature of any email service, and the ease of use and customization options when creating a drip sequence are typically make or break features for many users. To get started with an automation in SendFox, I'll hit Automations from the menu and then click Create Automation Series. Next, I need to select the list that I want the automation to apply to, and here I'm given a pretty straightforward automation builder. Now, the trigger is being added to the list, and then you'll compose an email for each part of the sequence. This is probably my favorite part of the SendFox UI, as it's just clean and simple. You can edit the delay or how long it takes for the next email to go out, but it only goes down to the hour. So if you want an email to send instantly, you'll have to switch the delay down to zero. So you'd want to do this if you're sending out like a lead magnet, for example, someone signs up on your website, you want that email to go out right away, switch that delay for that email down to zero and it'll go out instantly. So here we're getting a clear glimpse that SendFox is in fact using a tag-based system, but it's disguising it as a list-based system. Now, I have to assume that they decided to mask the use of tags because they believe it'd be easier for the average person to understand a list, but I completely disagree with this decision. Even the icons look like tags, so it's like, make up your mind, sumos. Now, you can create automations to add new people to lists when they open your email or click on a link inside of it, but I was a bit underwhelmed with the feature set of the automations. One glaring omission is the ability to remove someone from the list. Even if you add them to a new list based on a previous action that they took from an email you sent, they still stay on the same automation with no way to remove them until the sequence completes. So while this feature set aesthetically looks great, it still has a bit of bulking up to do before it's ready for the big leagues. My favorite current interface for this is on ConvertKit. They seem to have really borrowed heavily from ConvertKit's UI in SendFox, but obviously ConvertKit has been around for a while. It's more mature and established than SendFox, so hopefully it starts to look more and more and more like ConvertKit over time. In the contact screen, you can see all of the contacts you already have, as well as which list they belong to. Now, it's worth clarifying here that you'll see a second list called My Test Contacts. Now, SendFox actually created that list for me when I sent the test email earlier in the video. It's actually a really cool and thoughtful feature I haven't seen in another ESP. Most of the time when you work on a company's email, you'll have a group of contacts that you need to repeatedly send the test emails to before you publish to the live list. So SendFox just kind of picks up on this and does it for you. I think that's really thoughtful. Now, getting back to the contact screen, you can easily create new contacts, edit existing contacts, or even delete a contact altogether. But one feature that lacks from the screen is the ability to remove someone from a single list. For that, you have to open up the list and then remove them there. It's just a few unnecessary clicks, in my opinion. Now, of course, you need to get people on your list, and SendFox gives you a few options for how you can accomplish this. First, we're going to look at their landing page builder. Now, typically, I despise landing page builders from places like email clients. Now, here's why. creating a great landing page builder is really, really hard. Very few companies have made truly outstanding landing page builders on any platform. So I admire AppSumo's simple approach here. They ask you if you want to add some images, some copy, and then it's pretty much done. The page looks fine. You can't break it. It just works. Now, in time, I hope they add a few more templates for this so you could at least have some say in the style that you present. But if they didn't, it probably wouldn't bother me very much because I won't use anything very advanced or complicated. The one downside of using this landing page builder is that you're stuck with the SendFox URL, but I think in a pinch, this would do just fine. Creating the form is similar. Just choose the fields you want, give it a name, and connect it to your list. You're ready to go. When I embedded this form on the thatltd.life website, it took on the CSS style of the site, so it fit in right away. However, it would make some sense to add some styling options inside of SendFox for those that need customization and aren't CSS experts. The last feature we're going to talk about is the SendFox RSS feed. Now, what this does is it automatically creates an email when you post on your website. This has the potential to be a sleeper killer feature for SendFox, and if it performs well, man, it's got me drooling already. So the concept here is essentially similar to missing letter for email creation. If you're not familiar with missing letter, it's been on AppSumo a few times now, and basically it monitors your website for new blog posts and then creates social media content based on those blog posts. If SendFox were to replicate this type of feature but for email, it would be really exciting. Now, oddly, this feature isn't accessible from the main menu, so I don't think that's a good sign. It might tell me they're not very proud of it yet. It's actually buried under your account details. So let's test this out. Click on your name, choose account, and then the second option down is RSS feed. Enter the RSS feed for your blog or website and then hit add feed. Then SendFox will monitor your RSS feed and automatically create draft campaigns so they won't go out live to your users. That'd be pretty slick if it works. Now, I excitedly tested this out and I created a test post and published it on the thatltd.life website. Now, I'll be honest, I wasn't very impressed. All I got was a few lines of text. No images, not interesting formatting, just kind of blah. Now, I didn't include any images in the post, but what I did is include a featured image. So my hope was that SendFox would go out and grab that image and use it in the actual email. So my advice is keep working on this, Sumos. It's a really cool idea, and you could definitely win me over if you knock this feature out of the park. Now let's talk about hitting the inbox. An email tool is only as valuable as its ability to get you in the inbox. So SendFox is using SendGrid to power its email backend. I thought I'd put that in a direct contest with my current email tool, which is Modic, and I'm using Amazon SES to do the actual sending of the emails. Now, we're not going to compare Modic and SendFox here because they could not be more different tools, as you need to be quite technically savvy to use Modic, but it is free and open source like WordPress. So I decided to use Mail-Tester to just test deliverability. It was quick and easy to set up, so I just want to be totally upfront that this is not a scientific or thorough test. I'm 100% aware of that. Here's the results. SendFox scored an 8.9 from MailTester, whereas Modic with Amazon SES only scored a 7.9. Now, it's worth noting that Modic was dinged for not having enough text to go along with the images included in the HTML Composer window. I did send the exact same email on both platforms, but for one reason, it just didn't go through as clearly on Modic. So that was definitely more of a Modic issue rather than an Amazon issue. So in this single unscientific test, it definitely does not establish that SendFox is superior to Amazon SES, but it does let you know that you're probably going to hit the inbox if you're using SendFox, and that is a good thing. So SendFox is a cool concept, and it has really interesting roots with a hidden tagging system and an automation platform that just needs more power. But in its current state, I think most people will get frustrated that it doesn't do that one thing that they need it to do. It's missing vital features like image resizing, an HTML editor, or even the ability to remove people from automations. I love the concept of using RSS to generate new emails, and that small touch like adding that test list when I created a test email just shows that a lot of thought was put into the creation of this product. Speaking with some self-interest, we do mostly WordPress at our agency, and so for this to be a take-my-money insta-buy, I'd really need to see some support for more WordPress-based tools, something like Elementor Pro or WP Fusion. Now, there is integration with Sumo.com, but that service just isn't really appealing to me or my customers. I think Sumo does really well with Shopify and e-com, but we just don't work in that niche every day, so it doesn't do a whole lot for me. Now, if they had totally nailed the RSS to email feature, I would have been in. But that feature is just too underwhelming in its current state. So in summary, there is a lot of good that's possible in SendFox's future. It will just depend on how long you can wait and see if it turns into something that's usable for you. You know, the team at Sumo is really talented and they're not offering the LTD as a cash grab, so at least there's that. In its current state, SendFox gets a 6.9 out of 10. If you enjoyed this review and you want to support the channel, there are a few things you can do. First, you can use the referral link each time you make a purchase over at AppSumo. This kicks us over a commission, but it doesn't cost you anything extra. That link is in the description, of course. Next, make sure you're subscribed to the channel. We're going to be putting out reviews nearly daily in the future, so make sure you don't miss a single one and get subscribed. The LTD world is on fire lately. There are literally two or three deals coming out every day that I'm excited about, so can't wait to make more videos for you guys. And finally, if you like the video, make sure you click that like button. Leave a comment down below. Let's ding that YouTube algorithm and send things crazy. I'd really appreciate any help on getting the word out about the channel. So let me know. Are you grabbing SendFox? Are you sticking with your current email tool? What do you like about it? Let's have a discussion down in the comments, and I'll see you in the next review.